Hello. I'll show you the incremental progress that you make on a weekday, by which I mean I only get to work on this in between the hours of dinner at midnight. So the first thing I did is I implemented the screens, and I would like to point them out to you, but if you take your mouse off, they go away. The status screens, which describe what you've highlighted. So not only are their positions in the queue highlighted, but also you get their stats. The attacks are not in that. You'll have to get their attacks firsthand by experiencing them. You have the same situation. Highlight one of your characters to see their stats. Your attacks pop up with their information. I will go ahead and blow through this real quick, and I'll show you the other thing I did. This is where you learned to use your team attacks, and unlike before, I have actually implemented a team attack. So here you can see I've got a team attack where if Alex assists Beru, it's 11 physical and 4 physical. On the other hand, if Beru assists Alex, it's 15 energy plus burn plus 11 physical. The other thing I implemented is wave. So here you can see an incoming wave of enemies. Waves are the foundation of any battle. You can't switch with them. No matter what you do, they progress forward. So the battle is very much arranged on top of them. Now, the other thing I did is I made this change where the slimes don't die. They're dead. This slime is dead, but they don't register as dead until your turn is over. And in this case, we had a series of three in a row, so this slime is not yet dead. And the reason for that is twofold. First off, it limits the absolute amount of damage you can do by stacking your heroes up 80 deep, because you're going to run into the problem that there are bodies in the way. The second thing it does is it lets you wrangle overkill. Now, this black bar, which I'm not sure if you can see, this black bar here is injury. Normally, injury is used on your heroes, and what happens is a quarter of the damage you take is considered injury and does not heal between adventures. Until you take a week off, your injury builds up. So that puts a limit on how many consecutive adventures or how many consecutive weeks of adventuring you can go on with any given adventurer. The same thing applies to the individual monsters, but it's not nearly as useful. However, you can try and get an overkill, which is where you fill their entire bar with injury. I didn't manage it, and it's still not dead yet because the events don't actually count as their turn. They're just events. But once I go with Beru, that slime over there will die. See? So I'm gonna go ahead and switch. Rah. The slimes. All right. Oh, now as you can see, they're not centered correctly, but that's okay. This is just the day-to-day progress of a hobbyist. That's it.